Yes.
Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Janvi Bajaj. I'm the anesthesia educator on An Academy, and today is going to be a very special session. We have one of our amazing students, Dr. Akanksha Nag, and she's here because she scored a mind-blowing rank in INICET. She is this year's INICET rank 9. So congratulations, Akanksha, on your great rank.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am.
So, Akanksha, can you give us a little bit of a background of where did you do your MBBS from?
Yes. So, I have done my MBBS from Lokmanya Tilak Municipal Medical College. It's in Mumbai. I have recently completed my internship in the month of June. And this is my first entrance exam of the MBBS curriculum in which I've secured an All India rank of 9.
That is amazing, Akanksha. I think the first exam that you've given, you absolutely cracked it. So, yes. Congratulations. How do you feel? Like, how did you feel when you realized that you got rank 9? Who was the first person that you called and told?
The first person I called was my best friend, Akash. And initially, when I saw my rank list, I checked the roll number. So, that took almost around 10 minutes because my roll number was on some 700th of page. And then I couldn't believe it. So, I told my brother also to check it 2 to 3 times. And I told my friends also. I had already given them my roll number. So, it took around 10 to 15 minutes to let that feeling sink in that, okay, I'm All India rank 9.
So at that, how do you feel now that you've had like almost a week to process it? You've had time to think about what do you want to do ahead? Do you want to go ahead, give NEET PG or take up a seat now? So how do you feel? Like you've had 1 week to process everything.
Yes. So I want to pursue MS General Surgery. So I'll take a seat through INICET. And mostly we have to join before this month end. So I don't think I'll be able to give NEET PG.
Okay. So, Akanksha, tell us, how did you study throughout your MBBS? Were you like a topper, every year topper, and you were like very sincere about your studies? Or did you take some years light and some years you worked hard? Was your preparation always NEET PG oriented from the beginning? Or you started realizing the importance of NEET PG more towards third and fourth year of MBBS?
So, ma'am, I've been a topper consistently throughout my MBBS. I've topped in my first year, second year, and I was second in my batch in my final year as well. So, during my first and second year, my way of studying used to be to clear the concepts, to understand the topic. And when I started with my final year, because of my seniors who had cracked NEET PG, I got more oriented towards studying for the entrance exam. So, that behavior of studying for the entrance exam, I think, came in final year. Before that, I have studied almost everything and not just the IMP topic in my first and second year. So that is something which actually helped throughout my MBBS days.
Okay. So for a beginner who's just starting first MBBS, like if they want to follow in your footsteps, so did you do the standard textbooks? Just the standard textbooks, or you did standard textbooks plus MCQ books and some videos from the first year itself, or you started realizing the importance of it later on?
So during my first year, we didn't have any such online platform, nothing sort of that we had. So I have read the standard textbooks, and whatever things I didn't understand from standard textbooks, especially the concepts in physiology, I did use MCQ books for that. Anatomy and biochemistry, the faculty in our college was very good. So I really didn't need much help from outside for these subjects. But physiology, because there are so many concepts and graphs, especially from Genong, graphs are asked in National Institute exams. So I did take help of the MCQ books. This is during my first year, just to understand the topic as a whole.
Okay, and did you start preparing any notes, any material that would finally help you in your NEET PG? Or did you mark in your textbook?
No, so, yes. So, during my first and second year, I didn't have any idea about a concise note which we have to read during our internship. I really didn't know how to go about it. I just used to read the entire topic and hoping in mind that I am able to cover most of them and understand what the topic is all about. It's only when I entered final year when my seniors told me that you start compiling notes so that what you're going to read in internship will not be the entire textbook which you have read in first and second year. It will be a very concise version. So this is something which any of the coaching class is going to provide you.
Okay. So you basically started preparing notes more towards your third minor and your final MBA.
Yes.
Which you
final year MBA.
Your internship. Got it. And coming to your internship now. So you had a very difficult internship. I believe you all were the COVID, the pandemic.
Yes.
Started your internship on 1st of March and the pandemic started on 22nd of March. So I think the whole of the internship went in the pandemic only. So how did you manage your duties? How did you manage your day during the NEET PG preparation? Because you being a first timer, you're giving the exam for the first time. I think you absolutely made sure you use your entire day. So give us an effective plan that you followed.
So fortunately, actually, it was like a blessing in disguise. Because we used to wear PPEs, so it was very clear to us that we don't have to work for more than 6 hours. And so I utilized that to my advantage. And we used to have duties and then we used to have off for the quarantine period as well. So all those free time I've utilized for my studies. So I have studied every single day during my internship. And even when I had postings where I didn't have to wear PPE, I just had to do the data work, I still used to study over there whenever I used to get free time, solve some question bank modules or go through some high-end topics, some high-end tables which I had saved in my phone. So that is how I managed during internship.
Okay. So Akanksha, you had roughly 1 year to prepare for your NEET PG. So did you have a plan or a schedule as to, you know, I'll take so many months to finish my first reading, my second reading, my revision. So I have to make sure that I finished it in time. And also, how did you plan? Basically, what I want to know from you is an overview of a year annual plan. And then did you have a monthly plan, weekly plan? And, you know, in between, sometimes you fall sick. Sometimes you don't feel like studying. Sometimes... so many times the exams got postponed. So how did you manage to stick to your schedule despite all of that?
So ma'am, when I started my preparation at that time, I kept in mind that NEET PG is going to happen in January. So my plan was to finish my first read by the end of July, August. That is approximately 6 months. And for that first read, I had a planner which was given to me by my seniors, in which I had allotted number of days for each subject. So for anatomy, I had 10 days, physiology 10, biochem. In that way, the time was allotted based on the length of the subject and the percentage of questions which were asked. So my target was to, I started with my first year subject followed by second year, because these are the subjects which I had read almost 4 to 5 years back. So that is why I started my preparation with them. And my agenda in mind was to finish that entire subject in those number of days which have been allotted to it in any permutation combination. So the day I used to have my duty, I used to finish, I didn't complete a lot of syllabus during that day. But then whenever I used to have an off, I used to overcompensate so that I am able to finish that topic before the deadline. And along with notes, I simultaneously solved the question bank, because question bank, I took it as a learning tool, not really like an assessment, because some new things are taught to us in the question bank. So I used to add them in notes. So I used to have monthly plan that in this month, I have to finish these many subjects. And whatever I am going to read the next day, I used to write it down a day before so that it saves a lot of time in thinking what you have to read today if you have written down what you have to read a day before.
So that is a very nice way of making sure that you stuck to your plan each and every day. And what about the days that you didn't feel like studying at all, or you know, you got late from duty and you were tired? So did you just come back and solve questions, or you just watch Netflix and you were like, okay, today's day I'll just rest and tomorrow I'll start again?
So the day, these days I used to just solve question bank and not do any sort of an active learning, or just, you know, see the high yield table. So whatever table any high end I used to come across, especially in pathology, there are a lot of tables. So I had stuck them on my wall in my room. So I used to revise them and just resort to mere solving the days. I used to be very exhausted. But the next day, I would ensure that I'm overcompensating for what I couldn't read yesterday.
Okay.
So in that way, I was able to finish.
Great. So Akanksha, there will be many people like you who will be doing their internship and giving the exam. And tell us, yes, how was your daily routine like? How did you manage to squeeze in time? Because many people get tired because of internship and they can't concentrate even though they have the time to do so. So how did you manage it?
So ma'am, even this also I realized in the first few weeks of my internship that I get very tired even if my shift is only of 6 hours. I used to wear PPE and that used to be very exhausting and tiring for the rest of the day. So I changed my schedule in a way that I used to study the entire day and go for a night shift so that I come home and I just have to sleep, and instead of doing it the other way around.
Okay, great. So you used to wake up absolutely fresh in the morning or afternoon and
yes,
start studying, give it your all.
Yes.
So that when you go for duty, you know that you've also completed your syllabus for the day. So you're at peace.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, great.
Yes, ma'am.
And do you think you would have, I mean, do you think the pandemic helped you or do you think that it was against you? What is your opinion? Because people kept feeling, you know, they get a lot of negative feelings that exams are getting postponed and everyone is catching up with that extra time. But how was it for you?
So for me, because I got a lot of time, I thought it really worked in my favor, because had I had a normal internship, I wouldn't have gotten that much of time. And I think first read is very important. It has to be a mindful reading. So if you get ample amount of time during your first read, your basics will be set right away. So I think it really worked in my favor. But overall, in general, the atmosphere during the entire pandemic was very depressing. I also didn't meet my friends for a very long period of time. And a lot of my batchmates had also come positive. So there was a lot of fear which was there among us. So that was there was a lot of uncertainty regarding it. But I took whatever time I could get to my advantage, because I know that this is an opportunity to I should utilize it completely.
Great. So you had a positive outlook towards whatever was happening, thinking that okay, it's okay. I mean, even if the exam is getting postponed or there is uncertainty, I'll use that time to my advantage. That is a great thing.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. So tell us, you told us that you did your first reading in 6 months. Then what did
yes,
you
do ma'am.
For those 6 months? Did you revise, have notes? What did you do?
So ma'am, I was utilizing printed notes, and for the first and second year subjects, I did use some other platform because I didn't remember anything what I had read in first and second year. Everything was alien to me, the biochemistry cycles I was reading after 5 years. So I did utilize them and I finished them off in my targeted number of days. Because I had already read my pre-final and final year subjects well, I simply read them directly from the notes. So my aim was, again, when I'm reading notes for the first time, to understand the concept, basically the why of everything. Why is this an indication for surgery? And the important facts I used to come across, I used to underline them with a pen, because facts are something which will require multiple revisions.
So you had one first reading and how many revisions till your INICT exam, which was last month?
Yes, so after my first reading, I was able to do 7 revisions before the INICT exam. So my aim initially was to finish first reading by August, July, August, and then do 3 revisions for NEET PG, which was going to be held on 10th of January. And then the exam, it went on getting postponed. So I was able to finish more number of revisions, which took almost a month until July.
Yeah.
So that is how I was able to finish 7 revisions.
Okay. So a lot of you must be thinking that, oh my God, with internship, she's done 7 revisions. How is it possible? But also take into account, guys, that when I mean, she had a very basic plan. I think this is what everyone follows. You should finish your first reading and you should have three revisions till NEET PG, that is in Jan, which is very much possible. Your first revision may take 2 months, second revision will take 1.5 months, third revision will take 1 month. Now, when you've already revised three times, your following revisions are hardly going to take any time. So every time you're revising, it's just going to be hardly 25 days to 1 month for each revision. So after Jan, whatever was the time, she finished four revisions because it became very beneficial for her. She had already read it so many times. So that was a quick revision for her, correct? And at that time, yes, did you ma'am. Add on to any new topics? Like, you know, COVID has come and this continuing change in the topics and all the new things that are coming in COVID. So did you read anything new at that time, or you stuck to whatever you knew and you were like, okay, the new topics, it's okay, we'll let them go?
No, for COVID, I had thought in mind that whenever I get a final date of exam, I will do everything about COVID just 1 or 2 weeks before that. Because so many vaccines came up, even the Sputnik vaccine, it just got approved before the INSET exam. So this was again an update. So I didn't read any particular thing about COVID throughout my preparation. I just read everything at one place. There was a lecture conducted by an academy by different faculties about different subjects which covered COVID in different aspects. So that is something which I watched just 1 or 2 weeks before the exam. So I had all the latest information about COVID compiled in front of me. And the vaccines which came recently, that was something which I had read. So COVID I had read just before the exam, because I knew that if I would have read COVID in January, then guidelines changed in the month of May. Then again, there were new guidelines in the month of June. So that is something which I had kept for last.
So I believe, Akanksha, you had not just sincerity, but also you had a lot of smart planning. Because a lot of people get confused in new and new information. They are trying to seek more and more sources all the time. But you had it filtered in your head that, you know, okay, this is going to be changing guidelines. So let me just do it in the end towards the exam. Whatever is the latest will come before the exam. All right.
Yes, ma'am.
So now tell us, what was your exam day strategy like? So what did you do the night before the exam, day of the exam? How many questions did you attempt? Did you get scared? How did you manage that anxiety? All those things.
So ma'am, one day before the exam, I shut all my books at around 8 in the evening, because I believe that what extra I'm going to achieve if I'm going to read till 12 or 1 at night, it's not going to be beneficial. I just needed sound sleep. So I shut all my books at 8 in the evening, a day before the exam. And I spoke to my friends, and on the day of exam, I didn't have any strategy. I was not reading actually anything on the day of exam. We had to report to the center quite early. During the paper, when I initialed, my first 5 to 6 questions were extremely difficult ones, the biostatistics questions, and there were 2-3 difficult questions in molecular biology. So I did get that rough patch initially in my first 5 to 6 questions itself. So, but because I've given multiple grand tests where I've faced a similar situation, I immediately jumped to the latter part of the paper. So I directly went to question number 180 and then solved the last 20 questions first, and they were very easy. So that gave me a confidence that there are easy questions in this paper. And then I solved the paper in a reverse manner. So this is something which I have been practicing with my grand test, because there are the number of questions are same, but the permutation in which they appear on the computer screen is different for different people. So for me, the tough questions came initially only. So I did get scared, but I knew what had to be done. So I immediately jumped to question number 180, and then I started solving the paper in reverse.
So this is like a proper topper advice. I mean, she has not just studied and revised her matter and been consistent with her performance, but she has also used that matter in grand tests. She's solved all the grand tests and also seen how to go about things. You know, if you get a roadblock during the exam, if you get a thought block, you don't know what to do. Instead of getting anxious, just move on either to the next question or take another slot of questions and start solving them. So Akanksha, how many grand tests? I'm just like, this question is right in the middle, but it's very important to address this. How many grand tests did you try to solve? Like, did you have something in mind? Like, I'll give a weekly Sunday grand test, or a monthly grand test or two in a month or something like that?
So this advice was given to me by my seniors only. One grand test per month during your first reach, and the initial grand test, don't take your mark seriously. The initial grand tests are just for building endurance, to be able to sit in front of the laptop for 3.5 hours, and you know, you get all those rough patch in between. So how do you handle that? How many questions you should attempt? How much should you leave? So to establish a safe zone for yourself. So this is why you give the grand test in the initial month. And once you have finished your first reading, then you give one grand test every 15 days. And those are the grand tests jinke scores you should take seriously, because you have finished your first read. So giving grand test is the single most important thing, because it is the test which has all the 19 subjects combined. So it tells you how well your preparation is going. And you have to review a grand test also, or else it is of no use in giving the grand test.
Okay. So, and was there any different preparation that you did for INI CET as compared to NEET PG?
So the only thing which I did extra was to do my previous year papers. And I had to do them, one should do them not only just once, they should do it at least 2 to 3 times. And they should actually read the topics which have been asked in the previous year paper. For example, last year in November, INI CET, they had asked HFNC, so oxygen delivery devices becomes an important topic. So I read that entire oxygen delivery devices, and then this year they had asked question on NRBM. Mm-hmm. So I had solved AIIMS 2018 onwards, all the papers, and PG I had solved last 2 years papers, and JIPMER one paper. So these are the papers which I had solved with more focus on the past year papers of AIIMS.
Okay. So Akanksha, I know you're not giving NEET PG, but if you had to give NEET PG, then what would your strategy be for that exam? Like between INI and NEET, you have roughly 1.5 months. So how would you have prepared?
Yes. So in that 1.5 months, I would have divided it into 30 plus 11 day cycles. So for 30 days, I would have again brushed past through all my 19 subjects. I had already underlined the stuff which I knew I would be reading a month before the exam. So I would revise that. And in the last, and give at least 2 or 3 grand tests, but review only the wrong questions. And in the last 11 days of the exam, like the month of September, I would just go ahead and do all the high yield things. Like in surgery, there are a lot of scores. There are cancer staging, milestones, IPCs, poisons, the biochemistry cycles, cadaveric dissection videos. These are something which I would have watched in the last 10 days of September.
Okay. So coming towards the end of it, one question I want to ask you is, how did you feel was this year's INI CET paper? Was it a standard paper, or do you think it has changed? What is your opinion?
I think this year's INI CET paper was a little different. There were less questions which involved critical thinking. There were a lot of one-liner questions, but again, the options were very close by. So even a one-liner question can become very tricky, because they had given options very close by. So one has to read carefully the question and then go and mark the answer, or else it will lead to a lot of silly mistakes. And there were many past year repeats, but that is expected in a Central Institute exam, which actually highlights the importance of doing past year papers. So it was a mixed question with less of critical thinking, many one-liners as compared to the November INI CET. Images were not of that good quality, but overall it was a moderate to difficult piece paper, like every year how it comes.
And how many questions did you attempt?
So ma'am, I had attempted 188 questions. I had left around 10 to 12, and those were the questions which I absolutely had either no idea about, or I was not able to even boil down to 2 options. So again, this is something which I had established through my grand test, that instead of going aggressive, I thought that, you know, leaving those questions would be better, because I am not even getting the extra questions correct. In fact, they are adding up to my negative marking, which is 1/3 in INI CET. So that is why I attempted 188.
Okay, great. That's what we keep telling students every time, that you should at least attempt more than 180 questions, so you get some edge in getting marks. And Akanksha has proven the theory true. So, on parting words, Akanksha, what would you advise to someone who has just started preparing for NEET PG? Maybe your juniors, immediate juniors who have started their internship and are now preparing for NEET PG. Three important points that you thought were very crucial for your journey.
So first is to study every day, even though your day is going very heavy. You can be able to take out some time to solve a QBAC module. For example, if you're taking a patient for some CT, MRI, you can just sit over there and solve one or two modules. So study every day, give early grand tests, and do a mindful reading. You should be able to understand what you're reading and not just reading it for the sake of completion.
Okay, great. What are the Unacademy teachers or resources that you used, Akanksha?
So I had watched Dr. Amrit Nasa's surgery videos. I have seen all his surgery videos and they were extremely helpful to me, especially the videos on cancer staging and management which he had taken. Then I've watched your videos on anesthesia, especially 2 to 3 days before the exam when you had brushed through the entire subject in the form of flashcards. And then I have seen Zainab Vora ma'am's Midnight Express series. Not all, I just saw those parts where I needed to brush through important topics, and Preeti Sharma ma'am's Kickstart Morning. Again, those were in a very topic-oriented manner. Only those weak topics I have watched those videos.
Great. So hopefully we have been helpful for your journey. And Akanksha,
yes,
what stream are you going to choose and why?
So I am going to pursue MS General Surgery, and there are one of the reasons is definitely Dr. Amrit Nasa sir. The way he has taught surgery, I really like the subject, and I also have an interest in oncology. So that is also one of the reasons why I want to pursue general surgery.
Okay, great, Akanksha, heartiest congratulations and all the
best.
Thank
you, ma'am.
To you for your residency journey. The journey has just begun. In fact, I think the exam part is much easier than doing residency. So all the best. And we know that you're going to crack every exam that you give from here on and also be a great resident. So
thank you
very
much, ma'am.
And thank you so much for joining us today.
You're welcome, ma'am. Thank you.